Hi guys, iClive has spilt milk back here, and it's absolutely fantastic news. We are going to have some races this year. We're going to have at least 8 so far at the moment. As you can see, we're going to have 2 in Austria, one called Austrian Grand Prix, one called the Styrian Grand Prix. I was quite surprised they didn't give it another name like the Red Bull Grand Prix or the European Grand Prix. But still, yeah, it's good. So that's on the 5th of July, the first of these Austrian Grand Prix. And then, exactly a week after, you got the second one. And then a week after that, we're going to be at the Hungaroring in Hungary, of course. That's on the 19th of July. And then we're going to set for a 2-week break. And we're going to come to Britain for the British Grand Prix and the 70th anniversary Grand Prix. I suppose it's fitting that Britain gets the epitaph for the 70th anniversary Grand Prix, as the first Grand Prix was raced in Great Britain, well, 70 years ago now, hence the name of it. You could have also called it English Grand Prix or Northamptonshire Grand Prix or whatever, but no, 70th anniversary Grand Prix is absolutely fantastic. I suppose you've got to say the European Grand Prix moniker for another time, in case there's another Grand Prix later on in the season that might have to use that name. So I suppose it's good to save that name and use it when you need to. Back-to-back weeks at Silverstone, 2 weeks after the Hungaroring. I mean, this is crazy. You can have three weekends of pure racing. It's a bit weird because we've had it for so long, and I think it's fantastic that we're going to get less. He can hear less of me and all the other people who love Formula One and all the rest of it, and we're going to let the action on the track do all the talking. So after the British Grand Prix, after two rounds of the British Grand Prix, you've got the Spanish Grand Prix week after that on the 16th of August. And then 2 weeks after that, we've got the Belgian Grand Prix at Spa. I'm so glad that's on there, my favourite circuit. And then the week after that, you've got the Italian Grand Prix at Monza. So this is going to be so much racing, so packed little time. I'm so glad that we got the British Grand Prix on there, and the Italian Grand Prix, and the Belgian Grand Prix on there. You can't have a season without the British and the Italian and the Belgian Grand Prix on there. This is a sin. I'll also say about Monaco as well, but I understand with Monaco, you've got these dates, and if you can't do those dates, that's it. That's the dates that are set aside for the Grand Prix. You can't, these are non-negotiable. So this is our calendar so far, guys, but at the moment, that's just provisional. It's going to be at more races to follow, possibly as well. Again, I heard that if things change in the meantime, I heard that the British Grand Prix, Germany would be prepared to step in for perhaps one or maybe both rounds. Could have one round at Nürburgring or one at Hockenheim. You could do it like that as well. Again, you could do like the old days, one at Hockenheim as a German Grand Prix, one at Nürburgring as a Luxembourg Grand Prix. What's been done in the past as well. Next I'm going to do is see where else we can have Grand Prix with my opinion on the situation in these various countries. I'm quite surprised Britain's on here as well. I mean, if any of you read the news, we've had a few days ago, we had more deaths due to COVID-19 compared to all the other European nations in the EU combined. So that's quite a scary thought. So I think we've got to monitor that situation very closely and see, you know, the health benefits of it all, the health effect of it all. And as I said, Germany's prepared to stand in if necessary. So now I'm going to talk through about other countries that could host Grand Prix. As far as I understand, you've got to have 8 Grand Prix over 3 continents to make it a world championship. But I'll start with Europe and see, go from there and see what else we can get from Europe. Well, we started in Europe, might as well see what we can get in Europe first and then go other places.
Okay guys, so as you can see, this is a map of Europe. So as I was doing this, I was quite surprised actually, the amount of races that we have in Europe now, there's only a few. So just give you a quick rundown of what's going on here. So the countries in grey are the ones that we've already have. 6 nations who have already confirmed to have a Grand Prix, i.e. Great Britain, Spain, Italy, Belgium, Austria and Hungary. Apart from those 6, there's only a few other countries that host Grand Prix in Europe. France, the Netherlands was meant to host one this year, but that's been cancelled, and Russia. In France, there's including Monaco as well. It's so small, I can't really get it on this map, but it's so basically the colours are grey are the nations already, as I said before, already host Grand Prix. The Canadians in red are the ones who are contracted to host Grand Prix this season, but I don't, because of the what's going on, I don't think they'll be able to host it no matter what. So it looks like it's only Germany in the green who in a position other than the other six to host Grand Prix this season. The reason why I think that is because France, well, I heard a lot about France, they're very on lockdown. I'm quite surprised Spain is hosting Grand Prix and Italy, because I heard they were quite big on the lockdown as well. So I heard Germany not so much, there's more freedom over there in Germany as far as I'm aware. Holland, they were very quick to rule out the Grand Prix, and they're very keen to come back on the calendar in 2021. Maybe it gives another season to prepare the circuit for 2021. And then Russia, as you probably heard, Russia's been quite badly hit by the coronavirus, so I don't think they'll would be in a position to host the Grand Prix in 2020. But hopefully France, the Netherlands, Monaco and Russia, they'll all be able to come back on the calendar next season for 2021. Okay, next continent, please. So, as you can see before you, it's a map of Asia. But before we move on too quickly, as many of you, as I just noticed, Germany, they're not actually contracted to host a Grand Prix in 2020, which, as this is a prize. So, but I'm just putting it on there as a basis that they're prepared to stand in and they're in a position to host a Grand Prix, so that's why Germany's on there. As you can see, now we're going to go on to Asia. There's many street circuits in Asia, Vietnam and Singapore. So I don't think Vietnam and Azerbaijan too. So Azerbaijan, Singapore and Vietnam, don't think either of those three nations will be able to host a Grand Prix. These things take a lot of planning with street circuits. The Middle East has been hit quite bad, so I don't think Bahrain or the United Arab Emirates and Abu Dhabi will be able to host a Grand Prix. So that leaves just basically China and Japan. China has responded well to the coronavirus. I think they, as being the first nation to have it, they'll be the first nation to, well, to get rid of it, to be honest. So I reckon China should be able to host it come July, August, September time. Japan, they haven't been hit too hard, so I think China and Japan, they're the only two nations from Asia that could be considered as contenders to host the Grand Prix in 2020. Let's hope all the others will be able to host it again in 2021. I was particularly looking forward to Vietnam, seeing what that Grand Prix is going to be like, but it looks like I have to wait till next year. Now on to North and South America. I know they are two separate continents, but just for the interest or convenience for myself, I put them both on one slide. So there's only one race in South America and Brazil, so put it all together. So we've got Canada, the United States, Mexico and Brazil. Out of all four of them, I think Mexico's most likeliest place to host the Grand Prix in 2020. I see Canada is very cautious about, like France, taking a very cautious approach to the whole scenario. Taking no risks. They're the first nation to withdraw from the Olympics. That was meant to happen in Tokyo this year, in 2020. In regards to that, I think Canada the most unlikely place to host it. The United States have got so many cases of coronavirus as well. I think they're really struggling to with the problem. And Brazil, if you've been watching the news, you know the country's president, he's got no idea what's going on. Out of all the four places that F1 has to choose from, if you had to choose one, Mexico would be the place to be. But I highly doubt they'll go with Mexico. But if they had to choose
one race that was continent to fulfill the continental requirement, they would probably choose Mexico. Lastly, we'll finish with Australasia or Oceania and the rest of the world. And there's no Grand Prix in Africa, it's only Oceania. So the only place in Oceania that hosts the Grand Prix is Australia, and I think they are able to host a Grand Prix. They're not being hit too hard. So in conclusion, I think it's going to be the 8 races we have already. It's the key that we have the 8 races, so we've got them in the bag, we've got them in the bank, and we get a season where people are saying, oh, it's only 8 Grand Prix, it don't count. So you can have the 8 Grand Prix, perhaps Germany as well, and the other two from the other continents to round it off, Japan and Australia. So we'll have the 6 Grand Prix plus Germany, I reckon, and then Australia, and then end in Japan. As it was in the 90s, we finished the season in Japan.